I missed it.
Driver's seat.
There's revival, and it's spreading like a wildfire in my heart. Sunday morning, hallelujah, and it's lasting all week long. Can you hear it? Can you feel it? It's the rhythm of a gospel song. Oh, once you choose it, you can't lose it. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. I've got an old church choir singing in my soul. I've got a sweet salvation and it's beautiful. I've got a heart overflowing cause I've been restored. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. No, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. When the valleys that I wander turn to mountains that I can't climb. Oh, you are with me, never leave me. Cause there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. I've got no church choir singing in my soul. I've got a sweet salvation and it's beautiful. I've got a heart overflowing cause I've been restored. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. No, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. Oh, 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 oh.
Good morning, Lone Star Cowboy Church.
Good morning.
How's that for an opening from that band this morning? We're certainly glad you chose to worship with us today. For those of you who are visitors, we certainly hope that you come back, that you like how we do things, and that you feel very welcome. And of course, if you're on the internet, good morning, and we're glad that you chose to join us also. And then those of you who come every Sunday, you're our heart and love and so forth, and we thank you. My little thought for today is, so much can change from one day to the next. Always look forward, not behind. Your best days are still in front of you. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you that we have the opportunity to start each new day with a new blessing and all of the things that you offer for us as we stand in your presence. We thank you for everyone who's with us today, Lord, and we ask that you bless us as we worship. Give us some rain, Lord. We certainly could reuse some rain on our fields. We ask that you bless us as we go to Athens tonight. Give us safe passage. Give us a message. And let us continue to grow in our Take America Back to God, our worship there. Bless our service today. Give us safety as we go home tonight. Bring us back next week. For all these things we ask in your name. Amen.
Amen.
We got a lot of announcements. Monday night is regular service. Dinner's at 6:30. Service starts at 7. Women's Bible study is Tuesday, 2 o'clock here at the church. Wednesday night Bible study, we eat at 6 o'clock, and then we have Bible study after. Now, Becky is going to take orders today for the new Bible study books for Wednesday night. We're going to study about King David, and it's going to be a two-book series, and the total price for those two books will be $12. So if you want to get with her today and go ahead and order your books for the upcoming weeks for King David, please do that. Don't forget, we have a fundraiser for our benevolent fund after church today. We're going to be set up right back here. If you choose to eat here at the church, that's okay, but if you just have to tell us if you want a to-go plate or if you're going to stay here and eat here at the church. Last Sunday, we had a really good meeting at the First Baptist Church in the Take America Back to God. There was a huge crowd. I'm not sure how many people, but it was wonderful. It was really a good message. The music was great, and our church was very well represented. So don't forget about tonight's service at the Living for the Brand Cowboy Church that's in Athens, and that starts at 6 o'clock. Children's camp for the little kids starts tomorrow. I think we're going to leave the church here at 10 o'clock. So if you're an adult going to children's camp or if you're one of the children, be here 10 a.m. Be ready to roll. Okay, for the big Take America Back to God conference that we're having up in Mesquite on September the 9th, out of the bundle of tickets that we, the church, bought, we have 25 left. Now, if you want to get one of those tickets and sit in the section that our church is going to be sitting, you certainly can. But if we need to get more tickets, we can buy another section next to where we are. So if you're planning on going on September the 9th and you want to go ahead and get your ticket, please go ahead and do so. We're going to turn in one more order for the blue denim shirts. Several people have expressed an interest in not being able to have ordered them before, but Becky will also take orders for that today. I don't know how Becky's going to do everything today. So don't forget if you want to do that. There is a new member class immediately after service this morning, and that's going to be in the pastor's office. There will also be a short meeting of all of the children's class teachers and the parents right here in the sanctuary right after church. So there's a whole lot going on today, so I certainly hope that you can stay. Don't forget the benevolent fund. The fee is $15 for lunch, and then all of those meetings, the new member meeting and the parents and the teacher meeting right here. Thank you. One more thing I forgot to tell you. Vacation Bible School is well underway. I have enough chips, enough cookies, and enough juice boxes to feed 100 children every night. So thank you, thank you, thank you. We are good.
She mentioned the parent and teachers meeting. I'm going to put that off just about 2 weeks. Let's get through Vacation Bible School, and then we got some things we want to talk about, maybe some exciting new opportunities in the children's department. So disregard the meeting today with the children's parents and children. Let's get through VBS, and then we'll bring this back up. Dana, come up and share a little bit about VBS.
Good morning, everybody. Well, Miss Wanda's okay on the food, and I'm starting to get in a lot of different items for the Vacation Bible School decorating, so I appreciate all of that. Let's go back and talk about our dates again. So Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, 26th, 27th, 28th, that's going to be the evening VBS that we do every year. We'll have it 6 p.m. to 8:15. We're going to feed all those kids, like Miss Wanda said, so bring them all. We'll take ages 3 years old to 12 years old, and if they're a little older, we don't mind too much. Bring them on if they're older than 12. I've got a place for them. I usually use a lot of teen helpers for logistics, so there's plenty to do. We always have teen helpers with our crafts because some of the crafts can get very busy, and we always like to have plenty of kids on hand to help out the younger ages, the 3 to 4s and the 5 to 6s. You know, so bring your kids. We'll love on them, and we'll talk about Jesus to them. And we usually have a lot of children that accept the Lord during that time, at least feeling Him moving in their lives, and they witness Him moving in our lives. Amen. All right. So anyway, then Saturday is our water day. So swimsuits, the kids are going to get wet. For the 3 and 4 year olds, we ask that some of the parents definitely stay and help us keep an eye on those littles. just to make sure they don't get on the big slides and get hurt, or, you know, that we can kind of keep them in one certain area to play. So if you do have little kids that you're bringing, you know them as well as we do. So just help us keep an eye on them and pay attention to them and help us keep them corralled with their age group so nobody runs over anyone else. And we're decorating next Sunday after church. We'll start about 2 p.m. so we have time to go and eat and get our strength up, take our Advil, and then come back and get busy. So about 2 p.m. we'll show up here and decorate all three of the rooms, and then we might set up some things out in the arena for the games. I still need some older teens to come out. You know, if you're 16, 17, 18, don't think that you're out of it. We've got stuff for y'all to do, too, to help with, like, the 3 and 4s and logistics. Logistics are so important to make sure every child gets where they need to be going. All right, so I have pretty much everyone is signed up. Again, I'm going to mention that the 3 to 4 group can use some adults to come in, maybe run a game, run a craft or something like that, just to help out. So no matter if you feel like you can teach a lesson or not, you can come in and help them use some glue and construction paper and scissors and different things like that to rotate in with the 3 and 4 classes, just so that the teachers aren't on their own. And I have some registration sheets. I'll put them back on the table, and I'll be available during the break today. So if anybody has any questions or wants to see me about something, I'll be here. And also, I'm going to pass around final sign-up sheets for bring items, like floats and flip-flops and stuff like that. So it'll just refresh you in what I need, and you can sign up. And we are getting quite a bit of things in. So thank you. God bless.
All right, let's give these ladies a hand for everything that they're doing. You know, they do so much behind the scenes that they don't even mention in these little speeches right now, but we appreciate that, and all the teams out here that just try to keep everything rolling smooth out here at the Lone Star Cowboy Church. All right, now, is it good to be in God's house? A loud amen. Amen. Well, it is so good to be here praising our Lord in John chapter 4, verse 23. But the hour is coming and is now here when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth, for the Father is seeking such people to worship Him. Here we go.
Yeah.
up in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Glory, praise to God. Live this life. Amen. In John chapter 15, verse 13. Greater love has no one than this, that someone lay down his life for his friends.
Everybody has trials and temptations. Everybody knows heartbreak, isolation. But we can lay our burdens down. Lay our burdens down.
What a friend we have in Jesus. East to west, my sins are gone. I see grace on every horizon, and forever and ever his heart is my own.
Everybody has fears, everybody got worries. Everybody knows sorrow, devastation. But we can lay our burdens down. Lay our burdens down.
What a friend we have in Jesus. East to west, my sins are gone. Every horizon, and forever and ever, his heart is my home.
No more betrayal, for he is faithful. He fills me up and my cup runneth over. No more betrayal, for he is faithful. How he is proving it over and over. Over and over.
What a friend we have in Jesus. East to west, my sins are gone. I see grace on every horizon, and forever and ever his heart is my home. Forever and ever his heart is my home.
What a friend we have. What a friend. Righty. Mr. Terry.
What a friend of thought I am thinking, concerning a great speck of bird. Remember his name is recorded in the grass. For I want to comes, when it comes, I will greet him on a cloud that is floating in the Word. I will rise up, my Savior, to greet him on the wing.
Psalms chapter 147, verse number 1. Praise the Lord, for it is good to sing praises to our God, for it is pleasant, and a song of praise is fitting.
Last night I dreamed.
I can be so stubborn, caught up in my pride, like I'm the only one strong enough to ever win the fight. I can do it on my own, I never need a hand to hold. I can be so selfish, holding on to what is mine. I can find a way to place the blame when the world ain't spinning right. I can make excuses, but I know the truth is, when life gets heavy, my wheels let me down, and all my worries drag me to the ground. It's good to know, it's good to know, you took it all off of me, stood there in my place, and my lost soul swear book caught up in your grace. It's good to know, it's good to know, you took it all. But I still get anxious, have my days of doubt. If I could take a second to catch my breath and have a look around, I can see it clearer, there's a bigger picture. When life gets heavy, my will can let me down, when all my worries drag me to the ground. It's good to know, it's good to know, you took it all off of me, stood there in my place, and my lost soul swear book caught up in your grace. It's good to know, it's good to know, you took it all. You took it all. When life gets heavy, my will can let me down, when all my worries drag me to the ground. It's good to know, oh, 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 you took it all off of me, there in my place, and my lost soul swear book caught up in your grace. It's good to know, oh, 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 it's good to know, oh, 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 you took it all.
Yes, it's good to know. Well, want to make sure, remind everybody, they've already talked about how important it is to make it out there to Athens this evening if you can. You know, this moving, it's just going along fantastic. Amen? Amen. In Revelations chapter 6, verse 2, and I looked, and behold, a white horse. And its rider had a bow, and a crown was given to him. And he came out conquering and to conquer. Amen?
Amen.
He has fire in his eyes, sword in his hand, and he's riding a white horse across this land. He has fire in his eyes and a sword in his hand, and he's riding a white horse across this land, and he's calling out to you and me.
We all ride with thee.
He has fire in his eyes and a sword in his hand, and he's riding that white horse across this land. He has fire in his eyes and a sword in his hand, and he's riding a white horse across this land. And he's calling out to you and me.
we all ride with me.
And we say, yes, Lord, we'll ride with you.
We will stand up and fight, for we will ride
with the minds in heaven. We'll be dressed in white.
We'll be dressed in white.
And we say, yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, we will ride. He has a crown on his head, carries a scepter in his hand, and he's leading the armies all across this land. And he's calling out to you and me, will y'all ride with me?
Will you ride with me?
And we say, yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes,
we will ride.
And we say, yes, Lord.
We'll ride with you. We will stand up and fight.
Oh, we will ride with the armies in heaven. We'll be dressed in white.
We'll be dressed in white.
And we say, yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, we will ride. That fire in his life is his love for his bride. And he's longing that she be with him right by his side. But that fire in his eyes is his burning desire that his bride be with him
right by his side.
And he's calling out to us right now,
be all right with me.
Here we go.
Y'all clap your hands, come on.
And we say, yes, Lord,
we'll ride with you. We will stand up and fight.
Oh, we will ride with the armies in heaven. We'll be dressed in white.
We'll be dressed in white.
And we'll say, yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, we will ride. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Give him all your praise. You've been holding back. Amen. Love you, Lord. Amen.
Amen. Stand with me this morning. Father God, we love you and we praise you, and it's our privilege to be in your house where we can once again worship. Lift up the name that's above all names, the God who's the sustainer, the God who's the healer, the God who's the comforter. And Lord, there's many out there right now, as we all know from just last week, we're all really just faced with the fact we got many who are in need of a comforter at this moment. Lord, my heart goes out to several families in our church who are just saying goodbye to some who are taking the very last breaths, God. And I just pray right now that you'd be at the Bottoms family. Lord, I just pray that you would give them renewed strength, God. Lynn just... he's at the end of life and he just keeps holding on, Lord. And God, I just pray that you would take him when his time is right, and that you'd help the family walk together during this time. Give them renewed strength, God. Give them encouraging words from you and peace, God. God, direct their paths, Father, at this moment. Lord, we pray that you'd be with Mary Thompson's family as they too are saying goodbye to their mother, as the family's trying to do all they can with her being out of this nation, out of the United States. Lord, we just pray that you'd give them wisdom and direction, Father. I pray that you'd give Mary the right words and the encouraging words to help her stepdad and all the dynamics that are there, Father. Lord, we just pray that when her time is done here on this earth, you would take her softly and gently. And then, Lord, we thank you for families who surround us whenever we're in our last days. Lord, we pray that you'd be with BJ there in Florida as he's coming to an end of life and they're trying to figure out what to do. Lord, I pray that you would direct the family, God. Give them wisdom and direction, Father. Help them, Lord, not to do things on emotions, but help them, God, to make decisions on wisdom, Father. Lord, we ask that you'd continue to be with those prayer requests that we have. We pray that you'd be with Boy, Father. We thank you for his surgery and the success that he had, Lord. And we just pray that he would begin to feel better than he's felt in years. Thank you for Tommy being here with us today and doing better. We praise you for that, Lord. We just pray for continued healing in his body. Father, we thank you for what you're doing in Buddy's life. Lord, it was my pleasure to... God, for the last few weeks, it's been about taking his wife out and having lunch and just kind of giving her a place to get away and talk. Lord, it was exciting to bring Buddy lunch. Watch him eat a couple of donuts and drink a Diet Dr. Pepper. Lord, we praise you for that. Lord, you're bringing healing to his body. And we just thank you, Lord. We pray that he would continue to get stronger and healthier, Father. We pray that very soon, Father, he would be back here with us. Lord, guide and direct them as they're determining what to do in the next few weeks. I pray that you'd direct their paths. Lord, we pray that you'd be with the prayer requests that we have as a church. Lord, there's many. And Father, we could spend some time lifting up the prayers of your church, God, but you know each and individual prayer. Lord, we pray that you would work in the midst of our hearts and our lives and our families. Father, we pray that you would be with the children as we head to camp this week, Lord. I pray that it'd be a powerful time of worship, Father. I pray it'd be a powerful time of encounters with Jesus, Lord, and that these would be mountaintop experiences in these kids' lives, and they'd always be able to look back and say, I had an encounter with the Lord at church camp. Lord, bless us as we go back and forth. God, help us to have a great time together. Give our counselors an opportunity just to communicate and talk with our kids and help our children know as they come home that they are loved and they are accepted and that they're special in the eyes of Jesus. God, for all you do, we praise you. We thank you, Lord, for this day. We thank you for the opportunity to be in your house. And for all you do, we lift you up. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. I want to give you an opportunity to find somebody you don't know. Shake a hand or two. We'll let this band come off the stage, and then we'll start again. Children, you are dismissed. All right, I think it's time to begin. It's good to see each and every one of you. Hope you had a wonderful week. It's a fine looking crowd out there. We're going to be in Matthew chapter 23 today. I got to be honest with you, this isn't the message that I came here today thinking I was going to preach, but Lord kind of changed my spirit and changed my thinking a little bit. And so anyway, I'm looking forward to sharing Matthew chapter 3, verse 37. All right, all you talkers back here, sit down. It's my turn. Looking forward to camp tomorrow. We'll be leaving at 10 o'clock in the morning, and they'll be leaving here, and then we'll get back Thursday evening sometime. And we got five adults going, and we got 10 kids. So we're going to have a good time. We're going to camp in outside of Marshall, Texas. So we'll just right there on the Louisiana border. So anyway, be praying for the kids as they go, and just pray that the Lord will be very real and evident in their lives, and that God would do transforming work in the children. Remember, how many of us, who all here went to church camp growing up? It was a powerful time, wasn't it? Yeah, it's real mountaintop experiences in our lives. And we pray that it wouldn't be just a mountaintop experience, but it'd be a stepping stone in their life, that they would build on what they learned and the experience that they had with the Lord in camp. We're going to be in Matthew chapter 23 today, and we're going to start in verse 37. Jesus has already come to Jerusalem. He's just getting close to where he's getting ready to be crucified, and he knows that his time is drawing to an end. All the work has been done. Everything, all the preparation, all the lessons, or most all the lessons have already taken place, and he knows he's coming to the end of life. And many of us can understand getting a little older. Me and Ann was talking that when we turned 40, our eyesight started to deteriorate. That's true, isn't it? We know that as we get a little older, that our backs hurt a little bit more. Our shoulders, all of our shoulders hurt, I think, as some of you more so than others. All of our shoulders are sore, knees are going bad, and we're beginning to realize that we are getting on the tipping point of that mountaintop. And maybe some of our best physical days are behind us, and we know we're getting older. Here we got Jesus. He is at that moment in his life where he knows his time here on this earth is almost through. And church, the first thing I want to ask you today is, at this moment in your life, have you done all that you can and want to do for Jesus? Have you strived to be the example of Christ to all you come in contact with? Have you taken every chance you could to have an encounter with the Lord? See, that's what's so great about camp is our children are going to go, and you're going to be praying, and people are going to be praying for these kids to have another encounter with the Father. And have you had set yourself up with every opportunity to have the Lord speak to you just one more time in life to enhance your walk with him, to help you understand him, to give you wisdom when it comes to following and walking here on this earth? Jesus knew his time was drawing to an end. And church, we don't know when our time is through. We've got three people who are part of our fellowship who will pass on in the next few days. But church, we may beat them to the heaven's gates. Your time may be through. Your time may be limited. You may leave this property and find yourself in a situation where you stand at the gates of heaven. And I got to ask you, if you find yourself in that position, have you fought the good fight? Have you finished the race? Have you done what God has called you to do? Or would you say that you found yourself going through this life more just kind of going through the motions, just kind of getting tossed here and there by the waves of life? Have you pointed your kids to Jesus? Have you done everything you can to make sure your children or their feet are in the church? Have you done everything you can to have those conversations with your kids about the love that the Lord has for them in their life? And have you done everything you can to make sure your spouse knows that they are special and loved Have you done everything you can to make sure that your spouse understands that they're the very most special person in your life? Or have you found yourself more just living life together with no real concern about affirming one another and building each other up? God has given me a call, and that is to make Sheila better than she was when I got her. Okay? But she's gave Sheila a call too and said, make Charky better than he was when I gave him to you. Are we doing that? If our life is coming to an end, have we done all that we are called to do? Church, what's stopping you from doing it? Pleasures of life? Maybe haven't thought about it? Maybe you've just been too busy? Maybe you've thought other things are more important, like chasing after a career or chasing after finances or chasing after hobbies. And you was to be honest with yourself and you was to say, if my life was drawn to an end, have I done what God would call me to do? Maybe you would humble yourself, or we would humble ourselves and say, I've fallen short in areas. Church, today is a day whenever we evaluate ourselves and we ask ourselves those questions, and then we line ourselves up for what God would have us do. If we feel like we've maybe have become comfortable in our Christianity and we haven't really fought the good fight, we're just living life, then maybe today is a day we say, you know what, I'm going to be serious about my faith. I'm going to be serious about walking with the Lord. I'm going to be intentional when working with my children. I'm going to be intentional about loving my spouse. Tom, congratulations on your hole in one, buddy. That's awesome. That's cool. This preacher, it was a beautiful day, and he wanted to go golf. He didn't want to preach. He wanted to go golf, and so he decides he's going to kind of lie a little bit, and he calls his associate pastor, and he says, hey, I'm sick. I can't make it to church today. So associate pastor, oh, man, we'll be praying for you, and you get yourself better. I'll take care of service. And preacher goes out there, and he's playing a golf game. It's a beautiful day, and one of the angels happens to come by the Lord and says, hey, look down there at your preacher. He's out there golfing when he's supposed to be preaching. What do you think about that? God says, oh, I got this taken care of. He says, what, are you going to strike him dead? He says, no. He says, I'm going to give him a hole in one. Why would you give him a hole in one? The angel asks. And he says, because who could he tell? He can't tell nobody. So luckily, Tom's was on a Saturday, and he's not the preacher, so congratulations. But we come to the end of life. We got to evaluate. We got to say, have I been doing the work of the Lord? There was a time in my life when I was ordained, and a general superintendent laid his hands on my head, and he said, preach the word. Be an evangelist. Stay true to the gospel of Jesus Christ. Church, I had that calling in my life when I was a child, but church, you need to, or I got the call to ministry as a child and got my ordination as an adult. But church, you too have been ordained by the Lord to teach the word, to do the work of an evangelist in your communities and in your workplaces. Don't allow the devil to get you distracted and get you busy. Stay committed. Stay on fire. Keep your spirit hot for the Lord. Don't allow the distractions of the world to get you off focus. Some of us here are just maybe getting a little older in life, but some are just starting life. Rex is getting ready to go to college. How exciting. And so what we tell Rex and we tell others his age, stay hot for the Lord. Keep your fire hot. Allow the Lord to use you right wherever you're at. If you're on the rodeo team at that college, then be an example of Christ to that rodeo team in college. Allow the Lord to use you and your gifts and talents and who you are and your resources to build the kingdom of Christ right where you're at. We don't have to find ourselves late in life to evaluate our lives. wherever we're at this moment, we ask ourselves, am I the man or the woman God wants me to be? We allow him to speak to our spirits, and then we get in line with what the Lord would have for us. Verse 37, Jesus is going through Jerusalem, and he says, Jerusalem, Jerusalem. There's compassion in those words. There's a broken spirit in those words. Jesus says, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, you who kill the prophets and stone those sent to you. These individuals, Jesus looks at Jerusalem as a place that had destroyed the prophets, who had killed those who were doing the work of the Lord. And he says, if you would have just known how often I have longed to gather your children together. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, if you would have just known how much I long to bring you together, to bring you with me. He looked at these people as murderers, killers of those of the gospel, the Old Testament. How often I've longed to gather you together. Church, there may be someone here today where God would have the same plea to you. He calls your name and he says, how long I have longed to gather you to the family. But you have run and you've done your own thing, and you won't turn, you won't repent, you won't come back, you won't come within my wings. You're lost and you're dying and you're hopeless right now. But with tears in his eyes, he says, but yet I've longed to gather you. Church, is there anyone out there today who has run from the Lord? Maybe it's an absolute rebellious spirit. I do not want anything to do with God. I don't want anything to do with this Christianity. Maybe it's a spirit of apathy or spiritual laziness. We've refused to commit. We've refused to turn our hearts over to God because of our apathy or our spiritual laziness or our absolute rebellion. And the Lord calls out your name and says, I want you with me. Why would that bring anybody fear? Holy God who loves us. Creator who made the beautiful things of this world. Why would be afraid of him? If he says, I have longed to take these people who have killed the prophets, I've longed to bring them into my family. What have you done where he would say, I cast you to the side? You see, whenever we become Christians, when we say yes to the Lord, then we get this benefit. When we get serious about our faith and we say yes to the Father, we realize that we too are like these early people who killed the prophets and stoned those who God had sent. We've realized that we too are sinful people, that we've rebelled against God and our hearts are broken towards that fact. And we say yes to Jesus and we allow him to come into our heart and change our lives. Then we too have this benefit. I'll gather him up like the hen gathers her chicks under her wings. Church, where do you want to be? You ever seen a chicken protect her little chicks? She'll gather them up, kind of dust them up into her. Is that a beautiful image? Jesus was using a beautiful image to help us understand that God is saying that I will gather you up. I'll protect you. I'll give you comfort when you need comfort. I'll protect you from the devil's demonic schemes. But yet you refused. You refused, Jerusalem. And church, we cannot have the Lord say, Lone Star, oh Lone Star, how I wish to gather you up like a hen gathers her chicks. But you were unwilling. Rather, we've got to be a people with a soft heart for the Lord. When the Lord knocks on our heart's door, we say, yes, Lord, come in. I repent of my sin. Forgive me for the error of my ways. Help me to walk in your presence. Help me to express the joy of being in the protection of your wings. Use me, God, to build your kingdom. Light that lamp to my feet and let me have the wisdom to follow that light. But yes, Lord, I will follow you. These are some of Jesus' last words. If only. If only. However, you were not willing. You see, we'll all stand in front of the presence of the Lord someday. And is he going to say, if only, if only, but you were unwilling. If only, but you were unwilling. When we stand in the presence of the Lord, is he going to say, well done. Well done. You achieved what I needed you to achieve. You accomplished what I needed you to accomplish. You prospered where I needed you to prosper. You shared when I needed you to share. And you stood when I needed you to stand. And you ran when I needed you to run. Well done, good, faithful servant. Now come spend eternity with me. Or is he going to be like this encounter with tears in his eyes, bend down and look in the eye and say, if only we had plans for you. If only, but you were unwilling. See, we're all come to a moment in our life when we're confronted with the gospel. Scripture says he reveals himself to all man. Have you said yes to this Lord? This God who loves you? This God who just matter of later on that week stretched his hands out on a cross as they nailed those wrists to that cross. He symbolically said, with this blood, I give you life. This blood is for you. Take it, consume it, and let it change your life. Scripture says there comes a point in our lives where we need to accept that. We need to be confronted with that truth. We have to make a decision. Will I follow or will I continue to go my own way? Will I let those wings come around me symbolically, give me protection, give me a hope and a future? Or will I rebuke you and continue to be my own God? The question today for you is, have you made that decision? Does your life reflect the decision you've made in your life? If you made that decision in your life, does your life reflect it at this moment? If it doesn't, then go back and do the things you once did. Do the things that draw you close to the Lord. But if you're here today and you've never made that decision, today is your day of salvation. You've sat under the ministry and heard the story, confronted with the truth. Today's your day of salvation. So what do you do with it? You say, not me, Lord. Or do you say, here I am. I choose you. Thank you for choosing me. Let's pray. Father, we love you and we praise you. Lord, if there's anyone here today who they've made that decision in their life, but they, being honest with themselves, they've really just kind of just been going through the motions, God, I pray that you'd convict our spirits. And that we would once again remember the love and the joy and the peace and the satisfaction and the purpose we have when we walking in unity with you. And Lord, if there's one here today who has never said yes to you, never even realized they needed a Savior, but they feel you knocking on their heart's door, they know that they want to trust in you. And Lord, I pray that you would give them the boldness to silently say a prayer that would sound something like this: Dear Heavenly Father, I need a Savior. God, would you forgive me of my sins? Would you be the Lord of my life? Would you protect me with those wings as Jesus talked about? Lord, would you accept even I? I thank you and I love you. Now I'll follow you. Today I accept you as my Lord, as my Savior, and as my God. Father, I pray that that's the prayers of the lost. Those who are helplessly, were helplessly separated from you. I pray today, somebody, many people, say, God, I choose you. Lord, this is just a small portion of Scripture, just 3 or 4 script and verses. But it was a day, tears in your eyes, you said, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, if only, but you were unwilling. Look down upon us as individuals and as a church. Say, these are my people. And they go where I tell them to go. They are profitable for the kingdom. And they are in the arms of the Lord. God, we love you and we praise you. Take us from this place. Help us to be profitable for the kingdom. Help us to love our spouses as you'd have us love them. Help us, God, to point our children to Christ and grandchildren to Christ each and every day. And use us, God, to build your kingdom. In the name of Jesus, we ask these things. Amen. Man, God bless each of you. You're dismissed. Have a wonderful day in the Lord. If you receive the Lord today, talk to me. Let me know. I want to pray with you and encourage you. Don't forget about the dinner afterwards.